What is up, it's Mikey, and we got another Destiny video. This time it's the weekly Nightfall Strike for this week. Gonna talk about the modifiers, gonna talk about the stuff I got on all three of my characters, so let's just get into it. So first up, the modifiers. We have Epic, Nightfall, Arcburn, Light Switch, and Juggler. Really bad combo, not a lot of fun. We've done this one before. Arcburn, don't get hit by any of the anything. Light Switch, don't get smacked by anything. And they had a Juggler just to make it extra tough for you. And so for your weapons, really just always go with the burn. So I decided to go with my Fatebringer. It's got Arc on there. Patience and Time for my sniper, that's got Arc. And I got a new weapon, Iron Banner. We got the Jolder's Hammer. But really, the weapon doesn't matter too much. Just got to get that burn. And of course, before you head out to do this, you want to pick up as many bounties as you can that apply to it. All right, so usually once a week, I would do like a solo guide. Not for this one. I would never do this one solo. And instead, I highly recommend check out those LFG websites like DestinyLFG.com. I'll have links down below to different websites. This is the one that I use, and I always pick up random people. I don't even use a microphone. They don't care. Just get two people in there. It doesn't even matter if they're really good as long as they're semi-competent. Three is better than one, and it's just gonna make the whole thing a lot easier. I did not use my mic. I did not talk to the people. I just invited them. They didn't know I was on YouTube or any of that stuff. It's a great site. It works. Please use it. I would not bother with this solo. It's just gonna take up so much of your time. Really not worth the rewards. I would say kill out all the enemies before you take on Omnigul, but if you got random people, you really can't control that, so just really be careful. Creep slowly through the whole thing. Let's talk about my rewards. So my first attempt, I got 11 shards. Can you imagine if I did this solo, I wasted a whole hour, and then I ended up getting these shards? So that was horrible. All right, so let's go around the second time. The second time, I got 9 Ascendant Energy. You know, I have pretty much every weapon I want, but still, it would have been nice to get an exotic shard. We're gonna need that once the update drops. Third time's a charm, right? So my third time, I end up getting Broken Truth. All right, well, at least it's a weapon I can rank up, maybe try out or something. So there's that. Nothing really good this week for me. Again, I mean, it's not so bad. I've got all the weapons in the game. It is what it is. What did you guys get? Leave a comment below. Did you guys get anything cool? Hey, if you want to play with me, you want to hang out, I do the live streams, Twitter, Facebook, follow me on those. Links down below. Please take 3 seconds to rate the video. I'll see you next time. All right, so on the left side there, we have the new semi-auto pistol coming to Destiny. Talk about that. Talk about all kinds of new stuff that's coming to this game. So you can click on the screen. Links down below. Take it to my playlist. I'm always updating it. New Destiny stuff, tips and tricks all the time. And on the right side, we have an easy way to get Bloodthirsties in Advanced Warfare on your MDL. That's that crazy ass launcher that really sucks. So I'd show you guys how to get an easy Bloodthirsty double kills. That's what you need to do in order to get all those cool, crazy, awesome, fabulous camos. Anyways, click on the screen or links down below.